Hi everyone, Saeed here. Today I'm going to help you to level up your PowerPoint knowledge. You will learn how to animate your slides without using the Morph transition. Alright, as I mentioned earlier, in this video I'll teach you how to animate these two infographic PowerPoints without using the Morph transition. In fact, we will be using only the PowerPoint's built-in animations. Before we begin, I'd like to introduce you two new and unique templates I have recently designed that are sure to grab your audience's attention instantly. The first template is a pitch deck PowerPoint template. It consists of 37 different slides, including infographics. As you see, it resembles a book and is incredibly easy to use. But the second template is an infographic PowerPoint template. This unique template can't be found anywhere else. It includes slides for 2 and 6 steps, available in multiple colors with both dark and light themes. You can download these templates using the link in the description. Alright, let's get back to today's topic. You are going to become a PowerPoint professional. So let's dive in and start the tutorial. We learned how to design this infographic slide in this video, but we used Morph transition to animate it. Let me show you how to animate it without Morph transition. The first thing you should notice is the animation's behavior. If you remember, I told you we have a hexagon in the center and each point belongs to one shape. Alright, let's start by drawing a hexagon to the slide and align it to the middle and center. For your better understanding, let me change its color. Hold the Ctrl and Shift keys down and expand it like this, which all the points are in the outside. Now send it back. As I mentioned, this point belongs to this shape, which means we have to animate the shape from this point on the hexagon. So select the shape and in the Animation tab, add the line animation to it. By default, it goes down, but drag this red dot and drop it here on this point of hexagon. We should repeat this for the other shapes. For example, this shape belongs to this point. First, add a line animation to it and then drag it to this position. Remember, don't drag this triangle. Click on it when it changes to a little circle. Adjust the path of animation. Anyway, you should repeat this process for the other shapes according to the points they belong. Alright, we don't need this hexagon anymore. We can delete it. For the text boxes, the process is the same, but it is better to align them in a straight line. Okay, select your text box and add line animation, then drag it to this position. Repeat this for the other text boxes. If you notice, all the text boxes are almost on a straight line. By the way, you don't need to be very precise. Let's open the animation pane. Now select the first animation inside the pane, then hold the Shift key down and select the last one. As you see, all the animations are selected. Now select Start with Previews for all of them. Okay, let's see a preview, but there is a problem. All the shapes are going to the outside instead of coming to the inside. What should we do? To solve this problem, you need to select all the animations and then hover your mouse on one of the lines. When your mouse cursor shape changes to this, right-click on the line and choose Reverse Path Directions. Now let's see a preview. It is good, but I don't like the animation's movement. It is so sharp. Let's make them smoother. Select all the animations and right-click on one of them and then choose the effect options. In this window, drag the smooth end to the end. Perfect. But what happens if I add a transition to the slide? For example, let's add a push transition. I change the background color because I want you to concentrate on the transition. We have a problem. Did you notice? We see all the elements during the push transition and then they enter to the slide. In fact, we have to see something like this. So how can I hide them during the transition? To solve this problem, you should select all the animations and then add the appear animation to them. But be careful, you should select the animation from here. If you choose your animation from this menu, the line animations will be replaced with the new animation. We don't want that, we want to add a new animation to the shapes, so select it from here and drag them to the top. Make sure to select Start with Previews for them. Alright, let's see the final result. I hope the first part was useful. If it was, please like and subscribe to the channel and ring the notification bell for additional upcoming videos. Alright, let's get back to the next part. We learned how to design this infographic PowerPoint in this video, but we used Morph Transition. Let me teach you how to animate it without Morph Transition. To animate the text boxes, we should use the line animation. Let me adjust it and see a preview. Okay, it moves to the outside. What did we forget? We forgot to reverse the animations path. So right-click on the line and reverse the animations path. Repeat this for all the text boxes. But what about the gears? How to animate them? We have to use the spin animation. Hold the control key down and select all the gears, and then add a spin animation to them. Let me open the animation pane and then select all the spin animations. Click on this little arrow to open the properties window. You can see the amount of rotation in this section. By default, they rotate 360 degrees, but I want them to be rotated 180 degrees. So click on this arrow and change the rotation value in this section to 180 degrees. Keep in mind, you have to press Enter. If you don't, your change won't be applied. So 180 degrees, Enter. Let's increase the smooth end to 1.5 seconds. Click on OK. Now select all the animations and set a Start with Previews for all of them. Let's preview. Perfect, but you know, in the real world, gears are not rotating like this. If this gear is rotating clockwise, this one will rotate counterclockwise. And the other gears get their directions from the previous one. So select these two gears and change the direction to counterclockwise. Okay, let's see the result. I know it is not obvious, but engineers will notice that. But what if I want to add a transition to the slide? We don't have to see the text boxes during the transition. What should we do to solve this problem? We learned earlier, you should select all the line animations and add the appear animation to them. Don't forget to drag them to the top. Also, you should select Start with Previews for all of them. Alright, your PowerPoint is ready. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you think you are a little confused, it's okay because this video was a little advanced. So watch the tutorial again and it will resolve your confusion. Alright, don't forget to subscribe and I'll see you next video.